right, onward and upward. A cabaret, and it looks like there's quite a few people there. Let's check that out. Carnivalos. Mischief. Looks like somebody's little beach house. Not bad at all. This looks like a place you wouldn't mind staying a night in. The real question is that cabaret even exist anymore? Cool little clock tower. I've seen better. So now we're talking. Up in the clouds. That's usually how they do it. They put a teleport location on the ground and then they build the club up in the sky. Well, it looks like I'm perfectly dressed for this kind of establishment. Pretty typical avatar. This is a nice big space. I'm surprised that there's nobody in there. When it comes right down to it, it seems that the fact that so many club owners build their establishments up in the sky, it seems like there's kind of a major failure of the infrastructure there. Because why would you do that if you didn't have to? Now look at that, it looks like I'm gonna have a front row seat. That didn't work. This place is styling. So this is pretty standard for a Second Life club, usually. No matter how sophisticated and cultured the place is, you end up with a stage and a bunch of stripper poles and girls who are paid pennies per hour to pretend that they're stripping and to talk to the customers. Like she's doing right now, I'm being solicited. These tables are really nice. Definitely an inviting atmosphere. Here they have the little loophole slot machine casino type thing. Gambling is, of course, illegal in Second Life, but everyone and their monkey's uncle has a gambling booth set up in their club. And there's not a damn thing that Linden Labs can do about it.